The first thing I asked Microsoft after trying out Python in Excel was, can I connect Python formulas in Excel to slices? The answer I got was no. But I've never been one to take no for an answer. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create interactive Python charts connected to Excel slices, which will enable you to build interactive dashboards containing both Python and Excel charts side by side, controlled by the same slicer. For this example, I'll connect Python to Power Query data, which is currently only supported for external data sources. That is, you can't connect Python to a query that's connected to an Excel table in the same file yet. My data's in a CSV file, so let's go and grab it. This is one of them. I'll import. And I'll go ahead and transform the data. This is just going to give me an opportunity to rename the query. And I just want to put QRY at the front of the name. Now, one of the fields I want to work with is the education field. And if we scroll across, you can see it only contains numbers, which aren't very helpful. But I've got another table in a CSV file. So let's go and grab that. That's going to allow me to translate those education level numbers into labels. So let's get that table. You can see there it's got the level and then the label. Again, I'll just prefix this with QRY to differentiate the names. So what I'm going to do is bring this data into my original table, and we'll do that using a merge. And the matching columns are education, and then in my other table, the level. So let's click OK to bring that in. There's my new column, but we need to expand the columns just to bring label in. And we'll rename this education level name. Another option instead of merging is to load the two tables to Power Pivot and create relationships between the tables, but I'm going to keep this example simple. Let's go ahead and close and load two. And here, I just want to create a connection. I'll click OK, and we can see in the Queries and Connections pane, I've got two queries. Next, I need to create a Python data frame connected to Power Query. And I want to connect it to my employee data. So in this cell here, I need to activate Python mode. So I can type in equals PY and then tab, or I can use the keyboard shortcut Control, Alt, Shift, and P. That also jumps me into the formula bar to type my Python. So I'm going to call this data frame DF1, and it's going to equal my query. Now I can't select it using the mouse, but I can use the new Excel function, Excel, and then type in the query name, or use the autocomplete to select it from the list. So there it is there, I'll just tab to select it. Then I need to specify that headers are true. That is, my data table in my query has headers. And close parentheses. Now I should point out that Python formulas are case sensitive, just like Power Query. So to complete the formula, Control and Enter. And there's my first data frame. Now I like to just put a note to the left of the data frame tells me what this data frame represents, because they can get out of hand quite quickly. So this is DF1, and it's the query employee data. Now, because this is a data type, I can click on the icon here and get a preview of the data in the data frame. It shows me some of the columns. I've got a massive table, so it just gives me some of them, and it shows me the first five and last five rows of the data. I can see here I've got 1469 rows. Actually, it's 1470 because the first row is zero based, so it starts numbering from zero. I can also click on the widget here and bring in data into my worksheet, either a preview or some of this other information. I'm going to leave it in the data frame collapsed for the purpose of this tutorial. Now, the chart I want to build enables the user to filter employee data using a slicer for the education level. So I need a pivot table for the slicer to connect to and to return the selections made in the slicer. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to use the query data for my pivot table. So I'm going to right click and change the load to setting to a pivot table report. And I'm just going to pop it in this cell here. I'll click OK. Let's move that out of the way. And we'll bring the pivot table fields over beside the pivot table. Let's make it a bit bigger. So here I want the education level name in the row labels. I don't need the grand total, so right click, remove that. Let's rename the column header education level and we'll make the column a bit wider. Now I also need a slicer for this field, so right click, add a slicer, and let's just bring it over here for now. I'll right click the slicer and go into the slicer settings, and let's rename the display header education level. Next, I need to capture the selections made in the slicer from the pivot table. So as I select something in the slicer, the pivot table reflects that. It's kind of a cheating way to capture what the user has selected in the slicer. So let's do that here. And I'm going to Control Alt Shift P to go into Python mode. This is going to be called DF2. It's my second data frame. And it's simply going to reference these cells here. So if I press Control Enter, we can see the data frame and we can see the list. However, if I select only two items in my slicer, the pivot table filters. Now if I click on the data frame, we've got these empty cells. That's going to cause problems later on. So what I want to do is filter this data frame. Let's just expand the formula bar, Control Shift U, and we'll go down onto the next line. And I want to filter DF2. So DF2 filtering the column called education level, even though there's only one, to drop NAs and convert it to a list. Control Enter, and now it's a list. Let's just make a note of what we've got in this cell. It's data frame number 2, education level pivot. Next, I need a data set for my chart that contains the employee data in data frame 1, filtered based on the selections made in the slicer. So I'm going to create another data frame. Again, going into Python mode, Control Alt Shift P. This one's going to be called filtered DF, and it's going to equal DF1. Can tab to select it, open square bracket, filtering DF1 column called education level name, where the education names is in, not quite correct English, but let's go with it, is in this list. So where the education levels are in that list, it's going to filter the data frame 1. Close my square bracket and Control Enter to complete the formula. So let's make a note of what this cell contains. So it's filtered DF, which is DF1, filtered for the education level. Let's just make that column a bit wider. And now I'm ready to create my chart. I've got my data here that's filtered based on this list, which reflects the selections made in the slicer that are displayed in the pivot table here. Now let's rename this sheet Workings, and I'm going to insert a new sheet for my charts. Now let's just take a look at the chart that we're building again. Here we can see it contains the monthly income, age, job level, and education in a scatter chart. And you can see this one is currently filtered for below college and master education levels. The job levels are color-coded and the bubble size represents the education. Now I've already written some code, so I'm just going to copy it because it's quite a lot, and then we'll go back to our file. And in this empty cell, I'm going to use the keyboard shortcut Control Alt Shift P to go into Python mode, and then I'm going to copy the code that I've already written because it's quite a lot, and I'll paste it in. Let's make the formula bar bigger, Control Shift U, let's move that out of the way. So we can see it's using the seaborne chart, setting the theme, and then we're getting the filtered data that's in a data frame on the working sheet in cell B4. Let's just delete that and we'll check. So I'll click on the working sheet, and it's this one here. And it puts in the reference. Then I'm going to rename the column for the education level name because it's a bit of a mouthful. I'm just changing to education. Notice it's got a space on the end to differentiate it from the actual column called education. And then we plot the data. So we're using the age column on the x-axis, monthly income on the y-axis, the hue or color is the job level, and the size of the bubbles is education. And it's using the data in the data frame called filtered DF1. So let's Control and Enter to commit that. Control Shift U to reduce the formula bar. And it's put it in as an image because I forgot to change it to an Excel value. So let's do that from the drop down. And now there's a tiny chart. Let's right click and create a referenced picture. So there's our picture. The original one is still in the cell and they're linked. So if anything changes in the Python code or the query that it's connected to, it's going to update automatically and pick up the changes. It's pretty big, let's just make it a bit smaller. And we can go ahead and grab the slicer. So I'll Control X to cut it out, and then I'll paste it on this sheet. Let's apply some formatting to the slicer. So I'm just going to give it a gray color. We're going to give it 5 columns wide, and we'll just sit it above the chart up here. Okay, let's test that the slicer works. So we'll choose below college and master, and that looks great. Now let's build an Excel pivot chart and connect it to the same slicer. So we'll have a Python chart and a native Excel chart running side by side, both controlled by the same slicer. So what I'm going to do to start that chart is copy this pivot table. And the reason I do that is because that way this pivot table is already connected to the same slicer. So I don't need to mess about with slicer settings. Now this pivot table contains the average monthly sales by education field. So let's change it. We'll bring the education field down and take the education level out, and we want the monthly income down here. And instead of sum, I'm just going to change it to average, and let's apply some number formatting. So we'll put in the comma separator and no decimal places. And let's sort it from smallest to largest. Okay, now I can go ahead and insert a regular pivot chart. I'm just going to go with this 2D bar chart. Let's apply some formatting quickly. I'll get rid of the field buttons. Let's get rid of the horizontal axis because I'm going to add data labels. In fact, I'm going to add data labels inside the base. Let's also get rid of the grid lines and the legend. I'll format these labels in white font and make them a bit bigger and bold. And then we'll make these bars bigger. So Control 1 to open the formatting pane. Let's bring it over. We'll change the gap width to 50, and let's get rid of the border on the chart itself because that will be more in keeping with the Python chart. And before I move it, I'm just going to change the fill color for these bars to a shade of gray. All right, let's Control X to cut the chart out, and we'll pop it here beside the Python chart, and let's just resize it a little. And we'll center the slicer. Let's get rid of the grid lines. And now we have something that looks a bit more like a report. Now I nearly forgot to give the chart a proper name, so let's put that in. Average monthly salary by education. And lastly, let's test if the slicer works. So we'll look at college and bachelor. And there we go. Awesome. Now there are a couple of limitations you should be aware of. First, refreshing Python formulas also triggers a full refresh of the query it's connected to. So you might find it helpful to go into the Formulas tab and change your calculation option to partial. Partial is a new setting which puts Python and Excel data tables into manual calc mode. To manually trigger a calculation, just press the F9 key or set it back to automatic. And lastly, Python charts like these ones that are interactive using Python code are not supported in Excel yet. Hopefully they'll come, but I don't have any promises from Microsoft that they will. So I'm just hoping and crossing my fingers that we'll get them in Excel as well.
I hope you'll find these techniques useful. You can download the file for this tutorial from the link here. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more. And why not share it with your friends who might also find it useful? Thanks for watching.